Jesus' father. Jesus never claimed that he was born of a virgin. People assume that the Bible says that Jesus was born of a virgin, but it doesn't. Whereas St. Mark and St. John don't mention this idea, St. Paul, who wrote half of the New Testament, even contradicts it by saying, born a descendant of David, according to the flesh. One reason for making people assume that Jesus was born of a virgin was to attract the pagans to Christianity. In that period, the Persians were familiar with the idea of a Messiah being born of a virgin, and the Egyptians with the idea of a god being born of a virgin. Saint Matthew and Saint Luke refer to a mystery regarding Jesus' birth, but offer different genealogies. This is because the Bible recognizes the fact that, due to extramarital relations, lineages can either be real or supposed. The person we believe to be the father of a child is not necessarily the husband of its mother. Saint Matthew offers Jesus' real genealogy, since it is based on the father begot son principle. Saint Luke offers a supposed genealogy, since he uses the formula, Jesus was believed to be the son of Joseph, the son of Eli, the son of, etc. This explains, for instance, why they offer different names for Joseph's father. Between Adam and Noah, St. Luke's supposed genealogy has one generation more than the real genealogy in Genesis, which is based on the father begot son principle. Genesis says Arpachshad begot Shelah. St. Luke says Shelah was the son of Cainan and Cainan the son of Arpachshad. Both genealogies can make sense in case that Arpachshad first had Cainan and sometime later had Shelah from Cainan's wife, his daughter-in-law. This kind of relationship should not surprise us because Genesis mentions that Judah, a great-grandson of Abraham, had his hair from Tamar, his daughter-in-law. Tamar is one of the four women that St. Matthew mentioned in his genealogy for Jesus, and all of them had extramarital relations. Although the genealogy in St. Matthew is based on the father begot son principle, it ends with Jacob begot Joseph, the husband of Mary. Of her was born Jesus, who is called Christ. The sum of generations is therefore 14 from Abraham to David, 14 from David to the deportation to Babylon, and 14 from the deportation to Babylon to Christ. When we count the 14 generations from Abraham to David, we have to include both the first and the last generation. Therefore, we have to do so as well when we count those from David to the deportation to Babylon, and from the deportation to Babylon to Jesus. This gives us a division, Abraham David, David Josiah, and Josiah Joseph. Josiah thus marks the deportation to Babylon. Since St. Matthew says there are 14 generations from that moment to Jesus, and there are already 14 generations from Josiah to Joseph, Joseph and Jesus form part of the same generation. This means that Jacob had Jesus from Joseph's wife, his daughter-in-law. St. Matthew traced Jesus' lineage back to David because of a prophecy saying that the Messiah would be a descendant of David. Whereas with the idea that Jesus was a son of Jacob, he was a descendant of David, with the idea that he was born of a virgin, he wasn't. After offering Jesus' genealogy, St. Matthew tells us that Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but that before they came together, she got pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Later he refers to a prophecy about a virgin giving birth. This made people assume that Jesus was born of a virgin. However, St. Matthew refers to a text in Isaiah, and this prophet doesn't mention a virgin, but a young woman. St. Matthew could not openly say who was Jesus' father because the Jews rejected adulterers and the children born of such relations.